You are watching DHTV from California State University, Dominguez Hills.
And the next segment is as Mexico, as central as the Audiencia in central Mexico, is attempting to, with all of the information that it's getting about the North from all of the reconnoitering adventurers, they're going to make an attempt by which to go ahead and begin the journey north. But in order to begin the journey north, they have to go through a territory that it will be called the La Gran Chichimeca. So one of the things that's most important is let's take a look at this segment and let's understand very briefly the importance of La Gran Chichimeca. Now, prior to the Spanish arriving, the Mexica, the Tenochtitlan, had problems with the groups to the north, because the groups to the north control the trade routes over to the Hohokam, the Anasazi, and the Mogollon, the great trading centers up to the north. And then, of course, eastward towards the Mississippian region. So it's a place known as Zacatecas. And in Zacatecas, this is what will eventually the Mexica will call La Gran Chichimeca. So the Spanish are very well aware that in order to move up north, in order to follow the trade routes to the north, there is this group of native peoples that are in control of the trade routes to the north. And so there's a need for the Spanish to begin to carve out those trade routes. And there's a need for the Spanish to defend their northern frontier claims against the rival French. And most importantly, it is found, the Spanish find that there's rich silver mines, there's rich mineral wealth in Zacatecas. There's a need to secure that mineral wealth that's located just beyond what will be known as La Gran Chichimeca. So let's understand what Chichimeca means. All right, Chichimeca means, and you can understand this is a Nahuatl term. The Mexica do not like their enemies. They cannot defeat their enemies, so they're going to give them a name that you give to an enemy. You call them dogs. If you have an enemy, you call them dogs. So Chichimeca means the land of uncivilized dogs. And these uncivilized dogs consisted of a coalition of different kinds of linguistic traditions. And this coalition was very important because it prevented the Spanish from entering the north. They were known as Guamares, as Pames, as Huachichiles, Zacatecos, Excaxcanes, and Tecueses. Unfortunately, I misspelled Caxcanes. It's C-A-X-C-A-N-E-S. So those of you who are Caxcane, who are from Zacatecas, you should know that I made a mistake in the spelling of Caxcanes. It should be C-A-X-C-A-N-E-S. And that's my mistake. But then there's the Tecueses. All of this group, there's known as the Chichimeca, they will prevent the Spanish from effectively colonizing the region at the outset. In fact, these native peoples posed a military threat just north of Mexico City, just as they had done to the Mexica. Now the Spanish are going to have to deal with this particular group. And one of the things that's going to happen is they will go into a war. The Spanish will enter into a war that will last close to 3 years. It will begin in late 1540 and last between 1541 and 1542. And it will be known as the Mixton War. And the Spanish will be humiliated. And in this humiliation, they're going to encounter a particular leader who is known as Tenamaxle. And Tenamaxle, their leader, is going to share with them with regards to the Mixton War. in essence, is going to share with them that surely, in translation, says, surely you must be insane, or you must want us to kill you if you think that we will give you our land and not defend it. Who do you think you are, and who asked you to come here? And this is known as the Mixto Noir. There was an establishment, ultimately, with regards to war, there's always diplomacy. And in that negotiations, there's going to be the establishment of mining camps in Zacatecas. The mineral wealth is going to lead to more conquistadores, more colonists, more encomenderos moving up north to gain access to the silver mines. That mineral wealth is going to be very important because Spain is then going to take that silver and then dump it on the European market. And eventually that silver is going to reach Asia because Europe is interested in buying and taking in finding alternative routes to the Silk Road that's controlled by the Muslims. That silver, that's Mexican silver, eventually will reach Asia, which will finance the Ming Dynasty. Isn't that amazing with regards to international trade? But the establishment of mining camps in Zacatecas brought more colonists. So the Chichimec entered into what was known as hit-and-run guerrilla warfare. And it kept the Spanish society at bay until finally, after 30 years of guerrilla warfare, there was a new viceroy by 1570. His name is Don Martin Enriquez de Almanza, launches a full-scale attack and an enslavement policy. Those captured are going to be sent to work in the mines. So that in the 10-year period, the pacification campaign became successful, and by 1580, Spain is secure in the control of the Chichimec, in control of the mineral wealth of Zacatecas. Let's go to a film clip that helps us appreciate something about the Chichimec.
Desde el año 2008, la Comisión Estatal de Derechos Humanos Jalisco y su Consejo Ciudadano otorgan el reconocimiento Francisco Peramastri, así nombrado en honor al indígena Cascán, que durante el siglo XVI luchó por defender los derechos de sus semejantes. Francisco Peramastri es considerado uno de los precursores de la defensa de los derechos humanos, ya que sus peticiones de justicia, transformadas en escritos de demanda, fueron formuladas y proclamadas en documentos básicos para la humanidad. Es por ello que este premio reconoce a aquellos líderes sociales que luchan por los derechos humanos.
I was to use this short, brief film clip because it honored Tenamaxle in the Mixto Noir. And for those of you who don't speak Spanish, basically what this brief film clip is about the state of Jalisco and them honoring this particular man who fought for human rights. But when you go into Zacatecas, you will see the statue of Tenamaxli. And Tenamaxli was, again, understanding their environmental their decision to defend the environment, their decision by which to share with humanity that they have a right to exist as native peoples. And so in this particular case, we see a small, brief film clip that addresses the human condition in what was eventually be called the Gran Chichimeca. Okay, so that concludes this particular segment with regards to the takeover of the Gran Chichimeca.